This research has been done by Ruth De Frutos García, Ana Jorge Alonso, and myself, Emilina Galarza Fernández. The title is Communication in Processes of Social Change in Latin America, Bolivia, Argentina, Ecuador, and Venezuela. Firstly, in this research, taking into account the relationship among media, democracy, and power, four cases of social change processes in Latin America have been analyzed. These four countries, Bolivia, Argentina, Ecuador, and Venezuela, represent different models of the democratization of the communication. The implementation of neoliberal policies, even by democratic governments that emerged after the disappearance of the military dictatorships and the payment of the foreign debt created by them, have ended up in a network of social emergency situations and responses of the majority of Latin America people in the 80s and 90s of the 20th century. These responses have caused the fall of many governments in the new democracy period and have crystallized into political choices with the discourse of strengthening state structures facing markets and based on the democratic legitimacy of the political power. These new constitutions expresses a willingness to change regarding the previous governments, and all of them describe the communication rights and the citizenship as an expression, an extension of the classic right of free speech. Secondly, concerning the methodological issues, in this present study, it has been used the comparative law and a qualitative methodology, a method linked to the field of legal research and applied to the legislations of communication of Bolivia, Argentina, Ecuador, and Venezuela. In order to tackle both normative and media discourses from a critical perspective supported by the scientific community, the analysis of the legislative evolution has counted on historiographical tools of comparative law, taking as an example authors as Malson, but also on the critical discourse analysis, taking into account authors as Forero Hurtado and Pardo. In this sense, there has been an exhaustive work of identifying the different phases and players involved in each of the processes of social change related to communication and of our case studies in Latin America. Thirdly, the double dimension of economic profitability and the creation of hegemony turns communication into one of the strategic sectors of the new phase of capitalism. The integration and concentration of media ownership processes have resulted in the creation of large conglomerates that place civil rights associated to communication in the hands of large corporations, as has been said by the ethnosti Arsenault, Cast or Castells. The possible independence of media was in this way further undermined by outside interested, mainly those of the financial sector. In the discourse characterization as a social practice rather than just a product with the capacity to favor, support, and consolidate processes of social change where it has been affected mainly from social organization when demanding the opening of communicative spaces. But also, one cannot forget that governments have been those that have implemented legislative initiatives that may allow this opening. This has meant a direct confrontation with media corporations, which have come to occupy positions of belligerency against governments that have placed them, not only as mouthpiece of political opposition forces, but also as truly promoters or even creators of them. The presence in Latin America of a strong line of thought for decades in the academic field about the democratization of communication has produced a response from many social practices that have been unified on a set of experience and organizations that have revitalized these processes, as it has been affirmed in his last work by Martin Barbero. The expansion of public affairs, not only nationwide, but also on social scale, has been one of its most productive theoretical, but also practical contributions. This has had its consequences on the public policy undertaking, with a strong presence in regulatory framework, like Ramos and Sierras have said. Finally, concerning the discussion and the conclusion, we have to say that the reconstruction of public spaces in Latin America is essential after decades of neoliberalism and that went deeply into submission to US economic interests. It has expanded the gap of inequality and it has subjected the region to an horrendous plundering through massive privatizations and increasing concentrations of media ownership. A solution becomes an obligatory task for democratic consolidation. These challenges depend to a great extent of achieving a real plurality of voices in the communication scenes that favors social change in the medium and long term. A social change based on a cultural change that will allow the creation of new leaderships. The state should, therefore, become a guarantor of the neutrality of these public spaces, assuring the material conditions of access to all citizens and different groups. In the communication field, this involves the legislative in order to allow a sharing among the three main players: the state, the private sector, and also the so-called civil society. It should ensure that these legislative measures are inserted into a plural and democratic public state debate, which favors the creation of a new social bloc that promotes the strength and that promotes and strengthens these kinds of policies. Thank you very much.